Okay, so that's it, it's all cut. Just number it. Okay, so that's a complete bench. That's just ready to be installed. Now I just have to make sure this is spotless and there's nothing sticking up anywhere. So I'll clean it off, vacuum it, and clean it off with soapy water. Yeah, so that's the fully integrated ceramic bench, and you know, it's very much recommended. I think it's going to be great, hygienic, easy to clean, very good. I did do a test with the glue. That's the glue I'm using now, and that's as hard as a rock, and there's just no way that's ever going to come off the tile. Here's a piece of wood I glued onto it, and I'll give it a good test now with a screwdriver. So it's a paint that's been removed. The paint's still on the tile, and I'd say that if that was bare wood, that will have stuck very well. Okay, I'd say that that was a pass. If you do this type of work, a ceramic bench top, I'd highly recommend getting all the rear tiles in place as you cut them. So cut that one, stand it up, put it in place with tape so that it doesn't fall down, and then cut the next one, make sure it's correct. Cut the next one, make sure it's correct. Make sure they're lining up at the joins as you go. Another thing, don't glue the back of the wall, glue the rear of the tile. The problem with gluing the wall is that when you push them together, sometimes you get a bit of tile grout or tile adhesive in between the join, and that's going to make all sorts of problems, and it'll also make the tile line run out. Thank you. Okay, so all the tile joins are lined up. Okay, so it's passable, and now I'll move on to the other side here. Every job, even every tiling job, for instance, the bench compared to the wall, laundry floor, laundry walls, they all have their own methods and ways of going about doing the job. The marking pen I'm using is a normal CD marking pen. It's just a normal CD marking pen, and you can get the CD marking pen off the tiles with methylated spirits. There you go, you want to do a little bit of work, like cut out a thing for the electrician to install his PowerPoint. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, including the tape, 12 tools. If you want to do a professional job, 12 tools. If you want to bludgeon it with a hammer, that's one tool. I find the best way to set this up to glue it and actually stick the tiles on the walls is to cut each tile as perfectly as possible with no margin or no gap anywhere, and actually stand the first one up, and with that one in place, then cut the next one and so forth. Alright, well, wish me luck. I've got to cut that one out there, and this is the section here, and it's going to have this long skinny piece just going up just there, and it's probably going to break off there, I'd say. Okay, so that's it. I managed to cut this piece without breaking it, and what you're looking at there is one of the last tiles I'll ever cut in my life. I use a CD marking pen and I just get any of the pen off with methylated spirits. Okay, so it's very important at this stage put say 3 tiles on, or about that much, and just check that this margin is the same there as on the top.